Very good morning, students. Today, in history subject, we will see chapter number 7, India during the Maurya period. Now, in this chapter, students, we are going to see that how India was in Maurya period and the king emperor Alexander, what were the dreams to conquer the world and where he waited in India. Okay, and afterwards we will see also the Chandragupta Maurya story. So, let's start. In this 7.1, the Greek Emperor Alexander's invention, and 7.2, the Maurya Empire. Now, King Cyrus. Now, do you know around 518 BCE? Iranian emperor named Dariush had conquered the region to the northwest of India up to Punjab. Dariush had recruited some soldiers from this area into his army. Now, Cyrus was the king and he had a vast empire in Iran and it extended to the northwest of the India up to Punjab. And Dariush, he recruited some soldiers from this area into his army. We learn about this from the writings of Greek historians. Political relations between India and Iran were established during the reign of Emperor Dariush. Now, when the King Dariush was there, he built a political relation between India and Iran. This led to a greater exchanges in the field of trade and art. Emperor Dariush had introduced a uniform currency called Darik. Now here students, King Emperor Dariush, he introduced a currency named called Darik, and because of this currency, he had a greater exchanges in the field of trade and even the art also, in all the parts of his empire. This made trading easier. The capital city of Persepolis was built during his reign. Persepolis is in Iran. So, he named that city as a capital as city of Persepolis and it is in Iran. This is a Darik coin, student. With this, they used to do the trade. And it was very easy for them to do the trading also. Now, Emperor Alexander. 7.1. The Greek Emperor Alexander's invention. Means the dream of Alexander. What was it? Let us see. Alexander, the Greek Emperor, invaded India's northwestern frontier. Here, students, frontier means what? Alexander the Greek Emperor invaded India's northwestern frontier in 326 BCE. Now here frontier means what, student? A border between the two countries. Crossing the Indus Sindhu River, he reached Takshashila. Now where he reached? Alexander Takshashila. On the way, he met with forceful opposition from the local Indian kings. He defeated them all and successfully reached the Punjab. So while on the way, he just defeated some of the local Indian kings and he reached to Punjab. However, in this invasion, his army had to suffer severe hardship. The soldiers were eager to go back home. He therefore appointed Greek officer to administer the conquered territories. Now he administer means, student, what? Responsible for running a business. So he appointed, they were called as satraps. They were known as satraps. He started his return journey but died on the way back in 323 BC at Babylon. So where did he died? He died at Babylon. Today, Babylon is in Iraq. Alexander's campaign led to an increase in the trade between India and the Western world. Now, after Alexander, his campaign led to an increase in both the trade, India and Western world. The historian who accompanied Alexander introduced India to the Western world through their writings. So they were writing in the like in the painting form, in the art form. Greek sculpture influenced Indian art, giving rise to the Gandhara school of art. So the school art was known as the Gandhara. There were like arts paintings, sculptures. The Greek kings minted characteristic icon. One side the coin had a picture of the king who had minted the coin, and on the other hand, other side, a picture of a Greek god. The name of the king was also written on the coin. So they made a coin, two coins were made, okay, and one side of the coin had a picture of the king who had minted the coin, and on the other side a picture of their Greek god. One coin and both the side were the picture, and the name of the king was also written on that coin, not only the picture but the name was also written on that coin. So this is a coin. See, on one side the king and other side the name of that king also. Alexander silver coin, both the side, it is there in your textbook also. Later Indian kings also started minting similar coins. 7.2, the Maurya Empire. Chandragupta Maurya founded the Maurya Empire. People were tired of the tyrannical rule of Nanda, king of Magadha. Now here student, tyrannical means what? Excess power in a cruel way. This is the meaning of tyrannical. And who were they? They were the Nandas, king of Magadha. Dhananda, Chandragupta Maurya brought it to an end and established his own rule in Magadha around 325 BC. So what did Chandragupta Maurya did? He established his own rule. Okay. He won Avanti and Saurashtra and began to extend the boundaries of his empire. After Alexander's death, a struggle for power began among the satraps. He had appointed Seleucus Nicator was Alexander's general. For this, he appointed the Seleucus Nicator. He became the king of Babylon after Alexander's death. He invaded the northwest frontier region of India and the Punjab. Chandragupta Maurya successfully registered his aggression. The defeat of Seleucus Nicator led to the inclusion of the northwest region of Kabul, Kandahar and Herat in the Maurya. So all these three, Kabul, Kandahar and Herat, they were in the Maurya Empire. Megasthenes, Seleucus Nicator's ambassador, stayed back at Chandragupta Maurya court. His book Indica is an important source for the study of India during the Maurya period. Now in this book Indica, students, the story of Maurya Empire period, everything is written in this Indica book. There is an inscription stating that Emperor Chandragupta Maurya had built a dam called Sudarshan near Junagadh in Gujarat state. So one inscription is also there stating that Emperor Chandragupta Maurya had built a dam, and the name of the dam was known as called Sudarshan, and it is in Junagadh in Gujarat district. Emperor Ashoka. After Chandragupta renounced the throne, he was succeeded by his son Bindusara. Now after the death of Chandragupta Maurya, his son Bindusara, he succeeded the throne, and after Bindusara's death, his son Ashoka, Bindusara's death, his son Ashoka succeeded to the throne in 273 BCE. Ashoka had been appointed the governor of Takshashila and Ujjain before he came to the throne. So before coming to the throne, he was appointed as a governor of Takshashila and Ujjain. As a governor, he had successfully crushed the revolt at Takshashila. After becoming the emperor of Magadha, he launched a campaign against the state of Kalinga. Kalinga occupied the region of today's Odisha state. So, while Kalinga occupied students here in today's Odisha state. Emperor Ashoka conquered Kalinga. Ashoka's empire extended from Afghanistan in the northwest and Nepal in the north to Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh in south, and from Bengal in the east to Saurashtra in the west. So all this region were extended by Ashoka. Now the Kalinga War. Ashoka was deeply moved by the bloodshed of the Kalinga War. He decided never to wage a war again. Now Ashoka was deeply depressed because of this bloodshed. He thought just having only a fight, it is of no use. So he came to believe that truth, non-violence, compassion and forgiveness were the important values. So he gave more importance to the truth, non-violence, compassion and forgiveness. Ashoka wanted to spread these teachings among the common people, and therefore he had pillar edicts and some stone inscription engraved throughout his kingdom. So he wanted to express them in the form of a sculpture, like he built a pillar edicts and in the stone, some stone form like inscriptions, and these writings are in the Brahmi script. So whatever were written, the script was in the Brahmi script. In these inscriptions, he is referred to as a Devanampiyo Piyadasi, means what? Beloved of the gods, and he who looks on with the affection. This is the meaning of Devanampiyo Piyadasi. Understand? Another inscription stated that 8 years after he ascended the throne, he made the conquest of Kalinga and had a change of heart on seeing the devastation it caused. An inscription of Emperor Ashoka at Delhi Topda shows that he had put strict restriction on the hunting of bats, monkeys, rhinoceros and on setting fire to the forest. So after seeing the bloodshed and all that, so he put some restriction. And what was the restriction, student? Like hunting of bats, monkeys, rhinoceros and on setting fire to the forest.